Hi girls, this is Shehla. Today I'm going to do a very basic tutorial about eyes, the things that are most important about eye makeup. And here I have focused and you can see one of my eyes are done. It is a very basic nude eye. It has nothing like a very talented kind of look that requires a lot of effort. It is something that is very basic. So I want you to learn what steps you cannot miss if you are doing a basic eye. So the first step to do when you are doing a basic eye is to prime the eyes. I have used this balm by the balm, put a lid on. It's like a cream. It's applied on the eyes with a finger and let it set. And the next step I do is always set it up with a powder. So once the setup is done, the next step to do will be creating a crease if you have hooded eyes. And even if you have the other kind of eye which does not have a hood, you will definitely need a crease. Without the crease, you cannot map your eye and it is very difficult to apply the shadows if you do not have a proper crease. So creating the crease is like the most basic step in my makeup routine. So I do not create a very harsh, as it is a very nude kind of look. So this is done. I have created it a very basic. Now the next step to do will be, you always need to run the pencil along the upper lash line. This is how it is done. It will darken the lashes. It makes a visible difference to the look of the makeup. So when this is done, always map the face and you need to learn where to start and where to stop. You need a cream base for your shadows. I'm using this Huda Beauty. It has a cream base on one side and a glitter on the other. It is a very basic nude color that I am wearing today. I have applied it roughly because it needs to be set again with a, I will use a brush like this to blend it out and it will help in setting the, you can use your eyeliner, you can use the matching eyeliner, you can use the cream bases that are available, you can use the cream shadows at the base as well. MAC Painterly is a very good option for the base. Once this is done, I have few more steps that are very important. If you want to top it up with a shimmer, it has the shimmer on the other side. I will go in with the shimmer and I will stop here. Then I will go in the inner corner and go under the eye. Now this needs to be set as well. So I will use the same brush and I will blend out the glitter that we use. It is a very nude basic eye, the way I do it. Now you need to create liner. So I will start from this. I will create my wing first. And I will go in and I will go in under. Now I will smudge it out. Let me find the right brush. This is the right brush. So once this is smudged, smudge another. The next step after smudging that I always do is cleaning along the edges. Let me find a mirror. Okay. Once this is done, what you will do you need to darken the outer corner. So for darkening, I will use the shades this, this and this, and I will run the brush like this. Now, if you want to blend it further, it's totally up to you. You can blend it like this as much as you want. And the next step to do, you can never avoid the lining of the waterline. I used this brown shade by Linda Hallberg. You can use any nude, whatever is your personal choice. I will use this color today. And now I'm going to put on my mascara. Mascara, you cannot avoid. Your eyes, the eyelashes, they become very dull after you put on the shadows on your lid. So the mascara brings out the color in them and even darkens them more. I'm using Makeup Forever Smoky Lash Mascara. Makeup is not complete yet. There are a few more steps that I would do and I would like to discuss with you. So I will put another coat later, let it set. The next step to do will be, okay, now what you want the more blended look on this side. So I will take the light shadows, I will use this and this here, tap off the excess and run on here. It has been run. This you cannot avoid. Putting a light color in the inner corner of the eye brings the light out and gives a very distinctive look. And as you can see, I have done this brow, but I haven't done this one. Can you see how much difference it makes making a brow? I don't need a lot of effort on my brows, but I definitely need some. So let me find my brow pencil that I used. Here it is. What I will do, it has a spoolie on one side. I will run it through to clean any of the product that's in my eyebrows. The next step will be, I will take dark pencil and run along the lower edge. This edge needs a little more work. Once I have done this, again run the spoolie. Running the spoolie actually distributes the product evenly. This side has been done already, but I will just redo it a bit. So once this is done, the eye is ready. The last step to do will be putting on the gel. So I'm using this Benefit Give Me Brow Gel. Run. It further adds color to the brows and sets the brows in space, in the required space. It does not let them move. This is how it is done. So this is the tips and tricks tutorial for today. You cannot make certain steps, you cannot miss them. And as I can see now, it looks a little darker on the other side, so I will darken this one too. So thank you very much for watching. Please follow me on my platforms. Your feedback means a lot, and if you like my video, please share it. Thank you very much for watching. Love you. Bye.